getting hit and giving your opponent that face that it didn't hurt, even though damn well you know it hurt really bad, you can't show them that.
Chop, you ever spar someone really dirty that does dirty stuff?
No.
You're lucky. No. What happens if you end
up I did like in the beginning when I started fighting again. Like he'll be very dirty, he'll kind of like jump down very low and then pick me up and stuff like that.
So, it's good experience because you have to prepare for that.
Because yeah, there are people that fight like that. And that's what my dad would tell me, because I tell him, like, I fucking hate sparring this guy. He's like, you're going to eventually fight a guy that's going to end up fighting like that. You need the experience.
Yep.
And I would get mad. So sometimes he would drop down and I'll kind of hold his head down and start fucking hitting him. They'll be like, hey. I'll be like, well, he keys, you know.
And he trains here at the gym?
No. This was at another gym. Like
Robert Garcia's at RGB over there at Garcia's gym, no?
Where?
Hold this for a second.
At Team Garcia.
Oh, there too. Yeah, hell yeah. There too. Yeah, I remember I got into it with one of the dudes. My dad was going to fight his dad, a whole bunch of things.
Okay, who's the dirtiest boxer in history, in your opinion?
probably. like pro already, yeah. Kind of up there.
Yeah.
One of the dirtiest fighters?
Retired even.
I don't know. It would just kind of depend on what you mean by dirty. Because there's certain fighters that are dirty in the way that they hit you in the hips, on the top of the head, the back of the head. There's other fighters that they hold a lot. They'll hold you and then hit you. So I think it just depends on kind of what. Because, you know, you got a lot of Mexican fighters that they're very, like, dirty in that way. That they'll hit you in the hips. They'll hit you in the arms.
Chavez Sr. was great at that.
Yeah, they do that shit, you know, and that's pretty dirty because their tactic is to just hit you here. Now you got a dead leg and then now you can't move.
Like the guy that came in.
Yeah, exactly.
In the fucking ass.
They hit you in the shoulders. They hit you in the shoulders. I
hit you in the fucking ass, the fucking thighs. And fucking. I was so mad, bro. Yeah. I was like, bro, don't come over here fucking up. You know, it's funny. You could hurt my son's career.
Yep, it's true.
On the fucking ass.
You're right.
You know, and then they break and they hit you in the back of the head.
And that's the thing, that when it's sparring. Like, what you're trying to do that shit for? Yeah, I understand in a fight. Okay, that's the game plan, whatever.
Because he leans on his opponent.
Huh?
Tyson Fury, you remember when he licked the blood off Wilder?
Oh, yeah, he's fucking crazy.
He licked the blood off his ear.
That was crazy. That shit's nasty.
I think Usyk knocks him out.
The next time that they fight, are they going to fight?
December 21st.
December 21st. I think, I don't know, because... Fucking Usyk is bad. I think it's just kind of like the same thing when it comes down to Khabib and Bivol. Usyk and Fury, Usyk has to be perfect the 12 rounds. Fury's so strong that if he can clip him, he can change the whole tide.
If I'm Usyk, I have someone in Fury's locker room from the moment he gets there till the fight's over.
Yeah. That's true.
Now, I'm not saying it, I'm just saying.
But just in case. Yeah.
Because the guy Fury, when did he ever show power like he showed against Wilder? He didn't show that with Otto Wallen. He didn't show that with Ngannou.
Yeah,
he didn't show that with Usyk.
That is true. But I think at the same time, when you're fighting the best, it brings out the best out of you. And your
Usyk
training camps, your training camp goals are different because at the same time, when you, let's show, so like in Fury's case, when he's going to fight Ngannou, he thought he was going to walk through Ngannou, whatever. He didn't even fucking train.
I don't believe that.
I think he trained, but not like a real fight. He trained probably like...
Chop up, can I tell you something? You don't play with your food. If someone brings you a food, you get them out of there. I don't buy that. You don't get paid for overtime.
Sometimes you get too calm, like you believe the hype, and then when you're going to fight somebody that's in the UFC, you think, this and that.
Or he's not that good and he got exposed.
Okay, in that case, then what happened with Fury? I mean, with Usyk. He didn't get exposed. That was a very good fight.
The ref stopped Usyk from knocking him out.
Yeah, but fucking Fury looked way different. Compared to that Ngannou fight.
He got dropped with Ngannou.
Huh?
He got dropped, but
you could tell that training camp, he just wasn't...
All I saw was Fury bounce off the ropes, one rope, like WWE style.
That was a disappointing performance for sure, because you got Fury, that's the fucking heavyweight champion of the world, the best, you know, best heavyweight possibly. And then you got Ngannou that just comes in and fucking does them
pro
like that.
Pro debut.
Yeah,
never
exactly.
Fought amateur.
So, for sure, it was disappointing. But at the same time, you need those kind of performances to wake you up, make you realize... That, hey, what I'm doing, that shit's not working. I got to step it up.
Maybe it is. They're throwing bombs.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Fucking Oscar Duarte.
I can't show them the sparring, but it's very entertaining.
Yeah.
Oscar Duarte is very heavy.
I've been here for like an hour and a half trying to train, and then I stop and watch the sparring.
Bam's going to be here soon. There he is. The guy that he's sparring sparred, I was there with Spartan, sparred Ryan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Elijah Torres is badass.
What
bro,
does
no
FTP
joke.
Stand for? George Lopez says it stands for.
Fuck the police.
No, fuck that puto.
Oh, fuck that puto.
That's what
they said.
So, homie, did you win or did you lose, dog?
I lost.
How can you even ask that?
On me, huh? That's fucked up. That shows how much faith you got in me.
Baby, yeah, I believe in you like I believe in Jesus, baby.
That's right.
What's up, fam? You said that stands for F the police. I said no, it's F that puto. Right?
What time are you available at this point?
Oh, I'm training at 12. Well, like, I'm going to train at 9.
All right, we're going to watch some of the fireworks here. You can give them a play-by-play without saying the name. What do you
think? Elijah's on the ropes, you know, fucking good defense. Duarte's in there trying to work, but Elijah's very slippery, you know?
How's it going? Reporting.
He's very slippery. Bombs it's hard
away,
to hit him.
As they say.
Yeah. But fuck. That's the thing. Like I say, bro, even though you're blocking Duarte's punches, he's still like, you know, he's so strong, bro. Hey, but fucking Elijah got mad hard. He's coming right back, you know?
No, I said he sparred Tank. I was there for that. He sparred Ryan.
Elijah's badass, bro. And I think this next fight that he's going to have with Omar Rosario is going to be his breakout fight where everybody's going to see, oh, shit, this dude is badass. Yeah,
the sparring's so good. The whole gym here is watching. And whoever's not here is busy watching Jose Ramirez.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Sometimes that's the hardest thing about this gym is training because fucking you got Jose Ramirez sparring over here. You got Oscar Duarte sparring over here. And they're not just these are good ass.
Okay,
stories.
If you moved up to 140, how does the fight with you and Devin end?
Oh shit. I think it'll be a good fight. I think Devin's really good.
Oh, he's the best in history, the best pound for pound, the best fighter. He should be on Mount Rushmore boxing.
Ryan
exposed him. He's over.
It's cause. Look, I think Ryan exposed the fact that Devin Haney can't take a punch. But every round that Ryan didn't drop him in, Haney was fucking him up.
Because Ryan was gassed up.
Yeah, because he was in the shade.
Okay, so you see, steroids had nothing to do with it.
No, for sure. But I think it just, I think what it just showed, like I said, he exposed that Haney's very vulnerable. You know, when he gets hit, Haney's a good boxer. And when he was disciplined and stuff like that, he was good. It's just that then fucking Ryan would land that left hook and...
He kept his hand down.
Yeah, it's just that left... And then not only that, but if you notice, Ryan and Canelo got that similar hook.
Well, they both trained with Eddie.
Boom! And then boom! And you don't expect that shit, you know? You think it's a jab. You're going in to catch a jab and next thing you know...
But it's super fast for Ryan.
And it's really fast. Exactly. That's the thing.
You blink and it hits you. And it's the punch you don't see that hurts you.
And I think in order for you to avoid that punch is you got to be... Look at Tank. Tank is, I think, on another level. That's why Tank was able to fucking take that punch away from him. Tank was able to... And then not only that, but I think what had to do a lot, what affected a lot is that Tank's a lot shorter. So Tank, already as it is, he's short, and then he kind of goes in, it's harder for Ryan to clip that hook. With Haney's a lot bigger. So he was able to, you know?
But that answers your question. A lot bigger, just use the jab and carry the distance.
Yeah, keep
out of the range.
For sure, but Devin Haney didn't have punching
power
to keep
him. He didn't have a game plan.
He didn't have that punching power to keep the distance, you know?
So he doesn't have power, he doesn't have a chin?
He has power, but he doesn't have that power to, like, you know? I think especially at 140, bro, even though they don't got knockout punch power.
He does.
Every those shits hurt, bro. The punches fucking hurt. You feel them, you're like, oh, shit. Whether, you know, the only difference is some got that punching power where they hit you and you're knocked out. And others, they hit you and you feel it, but you're okay, you know. But they regardless, they all hurt. All those punches hurt, you know.
I agree. But let's see what happens. So, Chop, tell people where to follow you.
Yes, follow me at Chop_Gonzalez1 on Instagram.
Thanks for following him, and he's getting back in the ring in December.
Yeah, December 7th.
Stay tuned. Right now, he came to train, but he's enjoying the show so much.
Yeah. We're training the mind right now, you know? Taking notes.
Duarte is a monster.